The Pentecost Revival Hour telecast presents to you a message of faith and power. We've come to bring you the good news that Jesus Christ loves you. You can be saved, you can be healed, and you can be blessed by the power of God. All you need is just a little faith in Jesus Christ. So don't touch that dial. You stay tuned and be blessed in Jesus' name. Now let us go into our service for today.
Hallelujah. How many of you are ready to praise and worship the Lord tonight? It's something that everybody ought to do. Everybody ought to praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Come on, give the Lord another praise. Hallelujah. Glory, honor, God for giving us an opportunity to have everlasting life, meaning that our soul is going to live forever. You know, there is a second death, which is the lake of fire. Those who are saved are going to avoid that second death. We're going to live with God forever. And so we just thank you for the Lord for allowing us. Talk about our soul. You know, our natural body is going to go through a transition. We're going to go through a state of change. But our soul is going to live with God forever. So we just thankful unto the Lord for giving us an opportunity. Because all of us in here, the Lord didn't have to send his son to die for us. He already had a chosen people. The Jews were his chosen people. But since the Jews rejected him, that opened up the door for us Gentiles to be able to have access to Jesus, and to let him come and to live within us. And so we just thankful for the Lord coming. And we thank unto God for allowing his son to come to die for our sin, giving us a chance to one day go back and be with him forever. And also we get a chance to see all of those old patriarchs in the Bible, get a chance to go and talk, have a conversation with old Moses, with Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, to see how it was in their time. We can let them know the trial and the tribulation that all of us have been through. Because in order to be a servant of God, you're going to go through some trials. You're going to go through some tribulations. You're going to have to go through the valley and come out on the other side. So again, we're just thankful unto the Lord for what he has done and what he is continuing to do for us. And we are so thankful for those of you who are watching and listening to the Pentecostal Revival Live. And we pray that you, hey, call, if you are enjoying the broadcast, call someone else up. Let them know that you are enjoying the Pentecostal Revival Hour.
Amen.
Our program is basically mainly for people that are shut in, people that are in hospitals, that can't get out to the churches.
Amen.
And so the Lord has allowed us to bring the church to your house.
Yeah.
And so by television, by radio, you are able to experience the same thing that we are experiencing.
Amen.
In the flesh. And so again, we just thankful unto the Lord for allowing us to bring you the Pentecostal Revival Hour. We are a different ministry. We teach and believe that you can be saved, sanctified, and filled with the Holy Ghost. We believe that you can have power over the devil. That one time we all were slaves to sin, but Jesus came to destroy the yoke that the devil had over us, give us power over the devil. So now we no longer have to continue to be driven by sin. But we now have power over sin, so we can make a choice now. One time we couldn't make any choices. The devil made choices for us. But now since Jesus has destroyed that chain, then we're here to let you know that he can do the same thing for you. And we do want to let everybody know, sometimes people question, hey, can we come out to your church? And we want to let everybody know that you are always welcome. You are always invited, if you live in this area, to come on out to the Lizella Pentecostal Church. And again, this church address is 7545 Knoxville Road in Lizella, Georgia. And if you are enjoying the television broadcast or radio broadcast, call us right now. The telephone number is area code 478-935-8883. But if you can't call us right now, please at least write down the mailing address. The mailing address is 7697 Knoxville Road in Lizella, Georgia, zip code 31052.
Amen.
And also, if you have a computer and internet access, we ask that you log into the church website. The web address is www.lizellachurch.com. And if you go to that church website, you can find more information about this ministry.
Yes.
There are several tracts that are written by Apostle Phelps available at the website.
Yes.
So go there and check those tracts out.
Amen.
And also, if you need detailed information on how to get to this church or any other churches within this ministry, go to the church website, click on the maps and addresses button, then click on which church you would like to attend. You can enter in your address, and generate a map that will lead you turn by turn from your house directly to any of the houses within this ministry. So we just again thank God for all that he has done for us. We thank him for the technology enabling us to be viewed no matter where you are. If you have internet access, you can view this ministry. And also, if you are living in the North American region, you can also view the Pentecostal Revival Live. So again, we just thank God for what he is doing for us in these last days and times. So now we're going to see if everybody's ready to go on into our devotional service. So are you ready? Just open up and praise the Lord. Hallelujah. The devotional leaders coming at this time, give the Lord praise as they come. Pastor Phelps is coming.
I'm try to make you take it back. But you got to let the devil know that I'm not going to take it back. We thank God for the Pentecostal Revival Hour. I love the white Pastor Phelps is coming. And we have told the world time and time again who we are. We are professional devil whoopers. We are tag team working in the vineyard, casting out devils. And I want you to get your Bible and just shake it in that old devil face. And let the devil know, this is my Bible.
I am
what it says
that I am.
I believe what it says
to believe.
I come
to the
Lizella
Pentecostal Church
to be taught
the Word of God.
I will not
serve the devil.
I will not
live in sin.
Jesus Christ
died
for my sin.
And the blood of Jesus
cleanses me
from all sin.
I am
Christ-like.
I am
born again.
I have power
over the devil.
In Jesus' name,
amen
and amen. Praise God, praise God, praise God. You may be seated. Thank God for the Holy Ghost. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. And we thank God again for another chance to be before the world. To witness the power of God. And we thank God for all of you who watches us by television, listen to us by radio, and we thank God for all of the comments and all the support that we are receiving from people all over the United States. And we're just thankful to have the power to tell the truth. You cannot tell the truth without the power of Jesus Christ. If you don't have the power of Jesus in your life, you're going to lie. All liars, the Bible says, will have their parts in the lake of fire and brimstone. But to tell the truth, you're going to have the power of God in your life. See, one thing about Jesus, he don't believe in no shucking and jiving. And I thank God, praise God, because what's the devil he say? Is yea, yea, and nay, nay. Nobody can question Jesus about anything that he said or anything that he done because of who he is. And I thank God, praise God, that he have given us, here at the Lizella Pentecostal Church, an opportunity to provide a service unto him and witnessing his power. We are not here for any form or fashion, an outside show to the world. We are not here to do what most church people are doing. Because most church people, since the church ever been called a church, most church people are liars. They are thieves. They are robbers. Only a few people in the church believe and obeying the commandments of God. And I'm going to tell the truth. You see, because I'm not trying to collect no nickels and dimes. I don't need your friendship if you are not a friend of Jesus. You see, one thing for sure, Jesus is all in all. And he loves everybody that will obey his commandments. You may be seated. I have a message that I want to leave with you. And that's what the Lord have called me to do. Is to let you know the truth. Because a lot of people said some bad things about Jesus. And they told people a lot of lies.
That's right.
That we are all going to hell just because we go to church.
All right. Glory.
But I want you to know the truth, people. Your church is not worth a dime without the Holy Ghost.
Amen.
There is no church without the Holy Ghost. There is no Savior other than Jesus Christ. And if you don't have Jesus in your life and you are trying to please some man or some woman or some organization or some denomination, you might as well to catch hold to a donkey tail because you are getting to heaven as quick. But I come to tell you it's a better way. The message I want to leave with you tonight is titled, Doing What It Takes.
Amen.
You got to do what it takes.
Doing what it takes.
To get into the kingdom of God.
Amen.
And whatsoever it takes for you to get into the kingdom of God is documented in the word of God.
Amen.
If you are not doing what he said, that we all must do to enter into the kingdom of God, you're not going to make it. You got to do what it takes. And I want you to turn up in your Bibles. And one thing I love about Jesus, you know, he had to deal with church folks that didn't want to do what it takes to get into the kingdom of God. And he had to let them know then, and he had to let us know today.
Amen.
You got to do better than most church folks are doing to enter to the kingdom of God. I know you go to a lot of funerals, and I ain't never been to a funeral whereby the preacher didn't say that the individual, praise God, they were preaching the funeral for was going to be with the Lord, going to heaven.
Amen.
But according to the word of God, there are only a few people are going to heaven.
Amen.
The majority of the people that you see that is in this world is going to hell, according to the word of God.
Amen.
Because they are not doing what it takes to get to heaven. Jesus said in St. Matthew 5:20, I want you to look at this verse.
Amen.
And I want you to always remember what he said and who he said it to.
Amen.
Because that's the message to all of us. And Jesus said, and I'm reading, St. Matthew, the 5th chapter, and the 20th verse, and this in Jesus' early ministry, he said, except your righteousness shall exceed the righteousness of the scribes and the Pharisees, you shall in no case enter into the kingdom of God. You see that in your Bible? You are not going to enter into the kingdom of heaven except you do than the scribes and the Pharisees. Well, who are the scribes and Pharisees? What caused a person to become affiliated in an organization or denomination that called itself a church and identified as a scribe?
There you go.
Well, the Bible let us know.
Yes.
Jesus let us know.
Yes.
The scribe and the Pharisees, and on down the line, he also added the hypocrites. And he also added the Sadducees, because all of this group of people is church people. These are people that go to church. These are people, praise God, that are doing a part of what the church is supposed to do. And some of them did just enough to be put in hell. I'm going to tell you about these. I'm talking about what they was doing in the church.
Yeah.
If you are not doing enough, and according to the word of God, pray that your doing is going to put you in hell. And I'm going to prove it by the word of God.
Amen.
The scribe and the Pharisee were people just like you and I that went to church for a purpose other than, praise God, to manifest the power of the Holy Ghost. In order to go to heaven and to enter into the kingdom of God, you got to have the power of the Holy Ghost. And you ain't gonna get the power of the Holy Ghost long as you fool around with crooks. Everybody said there's a preacher, praise God, is not a minister for God. The Bible said there are many false prophets. He never said there was many real prophets, but he told you to beware of the false prophet, because the false prophet is a church group that has put people in hell. I have good news for you. I have good news. Everybody can be saved, but everybody's not going to be saved. Because everybody's not going, praise God, to exceed the righteousness of the scribe and the Pharisee. You may be saved. We don't have many people that come in this church. And I went through all of the services that God have told us to carry you through. And yet you have not connected with Jesus. All you have done, praise God, is the law. And the law is not going to get you to heaven. The law was never designed to get people to heaven. The law is your schoolmaster to get you to Christ. That's just like getting on top of a building. You need a ladder to get there.
All right now.
You can't get on top of a building, praise God, unless you have some kind of support or something, praise God, to get you there. And you ain't going to get to Jesus without the law. You may be doing a lot of good stuff.
Come on now.
And everybody do some good things. But your goodness, according, praise God, to what you think and the way you feel, if it's not the righteousness of God, you just ain't gonna make it. It's a sad commentary. We got so many people go to church.
Amen.
They pay their tithe.
Yeah.
And they don't never get beyond the law. Paying tithe is a law.
Yes, it is. Come on.
You got to go beyond the tithe. And some people ain't going to pay tithe. But God ain't going to open up his kingdom to anybody who is robbing him, who is cheating him, and who is not doing it according to the word of God. But he said, accept your righteousness. And I'm talking about good people. I'm talking about people Like the scribes and the Pharisees, every time the church door opened, every time Jesus conducted a service according to the word of God, all through the New Testament, every time Jesus went out to preach, the scribes and the Pharisees, they were there.
Amen.
I don't find them one single time, praise God, where Jesus was ministering, that the scribes and the Pharisees, they wasn't there.
That's right. They were there. That's right, Pastor.
But no matter how much you beat out people, if you are not doing what God has commanded you to do,
yes, yes,
He said in His word, you shall not in no case enter into the kingdom of heaven. So you want to go to heaven?
Yes.
Everybody want to go to heaven.
Amen.
But He done gave the instruction as to what you must do. What I must do to get to heaven.
Amen.
You got to do more.
Amen.
Then just do what the scribe did.
Amen.
And if I were you, and I don't know what the scribe, the Pharisees done, I certainly would be in searching and find out what did them scribes and the Pharisees do.
Amen.
And when Jesus said in the 23rd chapter of the book of Matthew 23:23. He said, woe unto you, scribes, Pharisees, and hypocrites. Matthew 23:23. Jesus is preaching. He said, you pay tithe of men, but the weight of matter of the law, you have omitted. Matter of the law.
Right.
It's love.
Yes.
It's judgment.
Yes.
It's faith.
Right.
And if you don't have those attributes,
right,
I'm just trying to help you. I'm just letting you know it's a better way than for you just to go on, praise God. So when I pay my tithe, well, Jesus said they pay tithe.
That's right.
But He said they ain't going to make it. They're not going to enter the kingdom of God. And some of us, we are so cheap.
All right.
Until if our tithe be in a sin, we're going to make sure that we ain't going over that sin. The righteousness of the scribe and the Pharisees. The Bible said they omitted the weighty matter of the law. And He said that weighty matter of the law is judgment. Some of us don't make no good judgment. What do you think about judgment?
Hallelujah.
He said judgment, mercy, and faith. That's the weighty matter of the law. But He said, these should you have done, and not to have left the other under. Oh, I'm telling you, I don't hear much of this being preached. But I got a message for you. The same-sex marriage group. I got a message for the less. For the
homosexual.
I got a message from God. There is no praise in heaven for people who are indulging in those activities. You got to be better. You got to be holy. Holy.
Holy.
Holy. And you can't be holy long as you're fooling around with people that are not holy. Of you, everything. As the Bible says, you got to love the Lord with all your heart, all your mind, all your soul, and love your neighbors and yourself to be holy. You got to have some feeling. Praise God for your fellow man. You got to have some feeling for the ministry of Jesus Christ. You got to have a desire that you want, praise God, to be a witness. Who don't know anything about, praise God, the power of God. You got to do what it takes. A lot of people don't care nothing about what Jesus said. All they're thinking about is that old flesh. Flesh and blood will not enter into the kingdom of God. You got to move on to the next level. As I said earlier, tithe is under the law. It is identified as a tenth. Well, you're not going to meet the requirement of God. And you don't even want to give a tenth, which is not yours. A tenth of everything that you have belongs to God. It don't belong to the preachers. A tenth belongs to God. That's God.
God.
He said, well, I can't do that. But what I'm preaching about tonight is you got to do what it takes. Jesus said, you got to pay your tithe. Then he said, give an offering. But guess what Jesus said? If you want to read it with me in St. Luke 6 and 38, this is the way Jesus addressed the issue of your giving. And if you don't follow the guidelines of Jesus, Jesus didn't come to bring the law. The law was already established when Jesus came on the scene. Jesus, I came to let you know who I am. I am the way, I am the truth, and I am the life. And no man is coming to the Father except he come by me. So the Bible said in St. Luke 6 and 38, he said, give and it shall be given unto you. He didn't set no amount because he done told you that you're supposed to pay tithe. In Malachi 3 and 8, he said, I'm going to curse you with a curse if you don't pay your tithe. But then Jesus came on the scene to let us know about our giving. Sometimes we wonder why we have such a difficult time in receiving our blessing from the Lord. And Jesus can't give you no more than you give him because he is a just God.
Amen.
He said, the just shall live by faith. The scribes and the Pharisees didn't recognize Jesus' teaching about the giving process. And a lot of times, you that are listening to this radio program, watching this telecast, you ain't gonna pay that much attention to what Jesus said because you don't trust him.
Amen.
And to get into the kingdom of God, you got to fully trust Jesus.
Amen.
You got to have confidence in him. And the word confidence means that you fully trust. If you don't fully trust him, he ain't got no space in heaven for you. But he said him, give and it shall be given unto you. That sounds to me like he is talking about what you give. That's what he going to give. But he going to do something. He going to bump it up. He going to take it to the next level. When you give, this is what he said. It shall be given unto you good measure. Pressed down, shaken together, and running over, shall men give into your bosom. For with the same measure that you met withal, it shall be given measure to you again. What do you think about the little woman that Jesus met? He was conducting a service.
Yes, he was.
And the Bible said when the offering was collected, this little woman, She gave two mice. She gave all that she had. And Jesus said unto the congregation, because Jesus always set up and watched what people give.
Amen.
One thing about Jesus, when he preached, praise God, he looked at people and what they are giving. A lot of times people don't want nobody to know what they give. They have it in their hand and they put it down where you don't know what they give. But Jesus knew what people gave. But Jesus said, this little woman gave of her need and an honorable, and he said she gave more than enough. But I'm going to get to it a little bit.
That's all right, boss.
And where he said, you got to do what it takes to enter into the kingdom of God, the kingdom of heaven. And he said, we must give what it takes to be saved. For example, I talked to you a little bit about what was preached to you here the other night in the 19th chapter of St. Luke. I want to show you somebody who gave what it takes. The Bible said in the 19th chapter of St. Luke, Jesus talked to us about Zacchaeus. Jesus always got somebody to show us what it takes to get saved. And according to the word of God, Zacchaeus made a sacrifice and obeying God. Maybe you want me to read it. I got it maybe kind of paraphrased. But anyway, I go back and just let you see it. Pastor Phil preached it last week, and God's been having it on my heart ever since to let you know he means business. And it tells us in the 19th chapter, in the second verse, it gives us the identity of this man that did what it takes. Zacchaeus, which was a chief among the publican, and he was rich. Now, rich people ain't doing much giving. All the people we read about in the Bible that Jesus had encountered with that were rich, when Jesus began to talk to them about their giving, they walked off and left. I can tell you about a lot of folks in this Bible.
Amen.
That when Jesus started talking about giving, they don't be bothered with you no more.
Amen.
But Zacchaeus here,
all right,
and the third verse is that he sought to see Jesus, who he was, and could not for the press because he was little of stature. But it goes on to let us know in the fourth verse, he ran before and climbed up into a sycamore tree to see him, for he was to pass that way. This is the feeling that Zacchaeus had about Jesus. He did what it takes. And when he got up in that tree, Jesus came to the place, and he looked up, saw him and said unto him, Zacchaeus, make haste and come down, for the day I must abide at thy house. Zacchaeus made haste and came on down.
Hallelujah.
You see, Zacchaeus didn't give him no lip.
No, he didn't.
Whatever Jesus told him to do, he did. And I tell some of you, you need to come up here and repent of your sin. You need to, praise God, get baptized in the name of Jesus Christ for the remission of sin so Jesus can save you.
Amen.
Oh, you come say, I ain't ready yet.
All right.
It don't take all of that.
That's right.
But Zacchaeus here,
that's right.
He easily do what Jesus said he should do. And it says here, I know people talking about him, but I'm telling you, if you get saved, somebody going to talk about you. Your previous church going to talk about you. Your crooked pastor going to talk about you. Praise God. You make some changes. Praise God. To get on the Lord's side, I said, you're going to be criticized. You're going to be scandalized. Ain't nobody ever got saved that wasn't criticized. They said, well, you know you ought not do that. You ought not have be fooled around with them folks. I thought you had better sense than that. But it said, you know, Zacharias stood and said unto the Lord, I'm telling you, he did what it took. He said, behold, Lord, the half of my good I give to the poor. This man said, I'm willing to give up half. He's a rich man, but I want to give it. I want to give, praise God, half of what I got. I want to give it to the poor. And he said, wait a minute, Jesus, I ain't finished my statement yet. He said, I'm talking about trusting in Jesus, doing what it takes. Zacharias, he said, and if I have taken anything from any man by false accusation, I will restore him fourfold. Not just give him back what I done taken by false accusation, because ain't none of you in here that ain't did something and took something from somebody by false accusation. There ain't nobody here that ain't did something that you ought not have done, took something from somebody that you ought not have took it from. But Zacharias said, if I done anything that was unethical, I'm not just going to give it back. Just give what I took, but I'm going to give it four times more. Give them four times more than what I took. And that don't represent tithe to me. Not when you're going to give four times. But see, if you believe what you say sometimes, it's more blessing to give than it is to receive. Why do you want to say it's more blessing to give than it is to receive, and you don't believe in doing it? That is more blessing to give than it is to receive, and you don't give no more than that dime out of a dime. I'm telling you, you got to do what it takes. Jesus said, you need to give good measure. You got to give it to him where he can shake it up, press it down, run it over, and fix it where it coming right back to you. Now, every time, praise God, that you do something for the Lord, it don't mean that, praise God, it coming back from the source that you think it's coming from. You say, well, I give you this, you go give it back to me. Jesus don't work that way. You don't know which way your blessing goes. You don't know which way God is gonna bless you. Zacharias said, I give it fourfold. What did Jesus say? I'm telling you, this man, he loosened the floodgate. This man opened up unto Jesus in a way where Jesus said, and this was the next word Jesus said. And Jesus said unto him, this day is salvation. Come to this house. What happened to bring the salvation to the man's house?
All right.
It was a behavior pattern here in his giving.
Yeah.
And the thing he wanted to do.
Yeah.
Hallelujah. you got to do what it takes. To get into the best of the Lord. Then Jesus said, for as much as he also is a son of Abraham. That man had faith.
Yeah, he did.
He's going to give half of what he owned to the poor. And that's all we are trying to do in this ministry. We are ministering to the poor. People worldwide. Who don't hear this gospel. We are paying through our nose. And some of us, praise God, don't have nothing to give. Some of us don't have no thought about those poor people that need to have this gospel preached. And it ain't right for me to have to pay it off and you ain't paying no. Of the Lord. This is what it takes. And then the next verse he said, this is where the statement is made. For the Son of Man is come to seek and to save that which was lost. That's what Jesus come to do. He come to seek and to save people that want to do like this man did. This is the mentality that we supposed to have for salvation.
Thanks for tuning in to the Pentecost Revival Hour telecast. We invite you to watch all our telecasts, Real Valley Cable in Fort Valley, Georgia, every Tuesday. Station WGNM in Macon every Sunday from 3 to 4 p.m. Real Christian Television Network, Channel 22, every Monday night at 11 p.m. Listen to our radio broadcast, Real Station WBML in Macon, every Saturday morning from 10 to 11 a.m. We invite you to come and be with us in our services. We're in three locations, Forsyth, Lizella, and Fort Valley, Georgia. We begin every Sunday morning with Sunday school at 9 a.m. Morning worship begins at 11 a.m. and all our evening services are here at the Lizella Pentecostal Church beginning at 7 p.m. We're in Bible study every Monday at the Lizella Pentecostal Church beginning at 7:30 p.m. We're also in Bible study every Wednesday night in Fort Valley at the Fort Valley Pentecostal Church also beginning at 7:30 p.m. So tune in for the Pentecost Revival Hour telecast in Jesus' name.